Okay, folks, I have quite a treat here for you today. This is a vintage Pioneer KP500 FM stereo cassette player. As you know, this is the Super Tuner, as you can see here, and this was the cat's meow back then. If you had one of these under your dash, you were the top dog. Anyway, I got this from the daughter of the original owner, and he recently passed away. Before he passed away, he told his daughter the specifics of a bunch of items that he had. And this one, he said he bought new and had never installed it or used it. I believe him, although it looks like it was probably installed as a display or something at some point, because you can see evidence of the mounting bracket being hooked up. It's a little egged out right there, and you can see that there's witness marks from it being installed in something. Everything else looks totally untouched, so this is still in the bag. All these wires are still wrapped up as factory. There was no evidence of any of the wires being plugged in other than being hooked up to my little terminals here, but no evidence of that. No evidence of a cassette ever being slid into it. Just an awesome, awesome player. I would say that it's new, and maybe it was set up as a display unit at a stereo shop or something. All the instructions and everything are here, even the original warranty card. Is that the warranty card? That's the warranty manual. There's the warranty card. It's still intact, never messed with. So anyway, beautiful, beautiful unit in the box. We're gonna test it here. We have it hooked up to a 12 volt power supply, an antenna, and a speaker. And I have it hooked up to one speaker so we can check each channel independently. I tested it just a moment ago. Everything works solid with the exception of the mute button. If you turn the mute on, it does not turn on. I imagine the contacts just need to be cleaned in it after sitting for, you know, 20, 30 years, maybe 40 years. Anyway, I decided not to do anything about it just because it's just as easy to turn down the volume as it is to hit the mute button, and I don't want to go opening up a virgin unit. So anyway, we're going to test it out. Again, we have it hooked up to 12 volt power, and here we go. So we'll start from the end of the dial here, just to show you we have, I guess, probably starts right there. So you'll see the stereo turn on. Okay, so let me show you a couple things here.
105.1
Let's get a stereo station in. Okay, so we have stereo here. If we switch it to mono, you'll see the stereo turn off. Switch it back, it'll turn back on. So there's that. Okay, let me show you. It gets super loud. I could turn it up louder, but it'll just hurt my ears. We got balance, so it'll fade out on one side, come back on the other. Okay, we have bass, so we'll take the bass out, then we'll put the bass in, hopefully you can hear that. Treble, we'll take the treble out, put the treble back in. Okay, loudness, hopefully you can hear it get louder there. Off, on, and we'll check the mute just to, yeah, see, nothing happens with the mute. So, anyway, that's the only issue to speak of. Finally, well, let's switch the channels here. So I'll set you down. We're going from the gray over to the green. So you can see we're hooked up to green now. And finally, we'll hook it up to our fine cassette here. This is the only one I could find, Andreas Vollenweider, Down to the Moon. And we'll slip the Vollenweider into the slot. Now we're hooked up. Here's our Vollenweider here. Show you, fast forward the Vollenweider. We can rewind the Vollenweider, and we can obviously eject the Vollenweider, but can see no crackling or anything when we do that. Now we'll hit the eject button, boom, back over to our classic rock there. I'm going to take you all the way through the dial just to show you that we get stations everywhere.
Bendiciendo la casa.
There are asking.
Just awesome reception through the dial, guys. There's one more thing I want to show you. but I can't remember what it is now. Yeah, I'm not sure, but couldn't have been that important. Oh, I know what I want to show you. Okay, so you see the little orange indicator there? When we turn the radio off, it turns off. When we turn it on, it turns back on. So I didn't show you that earlier. Anyway, just an absolutely beautiful FM stereo cassette super tuner. The KP500 is the one that you want under your dash. This, like I said, it doesn't get any more period correct than this, and this was the best money could buy back then. If you had this, you either worked very hard flipping burgers or you had rich parents. So don't miss it.